Are you well?
Yeah.
No, you're not a well. You're a person.
Welcome.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm delightful, thank you.
Nice to meet you. What's your name, please?
Josh Blue.
Welcome, Josh Blue. What a cool name.
Thank you. My parents gave me a stage name, so I had to go with it.
Yeah, I did. Josh Blue. Where are you from, Josh?
I live in Denver, Colorado.
Okay. Tell us a bit about you, Josh.
So, I have cerebral palsy. I like to get that out of the way early. Otherwise, definitely want to let you off the hook, you know? You're like, this guy is drunk, man. I do stand-up comedy. I know I look like I'm about to fall over, but I get it done.
Tell us why you decided to enter the show this year.
After the year we've had, I think the world is just ready for some laughter.
Yes. Hear.
I'm a laugh junkie, man.
I like that too.
Okay.
Josh, the stage is yours.
All right, buckle up.
All right. Let's go, Sofia.
It's really good to be here. You know, I'm not from California, but I look like I am. Just another wobbly guy on the sidewalk. I made $8 walking over here. Thank you. Hey, can you guys see this bracelet?
Yeah. Yeah.
Good. Just making sure. Yeah. Everybody always thinks that this is one of those copper magnetic healing bracelets. Like, hey, does that thing work? I'm like, oh yeah, man. I was in a wheelchair last week. Oh! I'm gonna put it on this arm next week. I better take it off soon, though. You know, I don't want to get too better. Might mess up my show, and then I have to figure out how to be a magic singing ventriloquist or whatever. Let's just say we're not getting a puppet on that thing.
Oh, my God!
I was back in Denver last week, walking down the street, this lady come up to me, she said, I think it's so inspirational that you're out. I was like, I'm on my way to the liquor store. I got $8 burning a hole in my pocket. I was at a restaurant with a bunch of friends, and the server went around the table and took everybody's order. And then when they got to me, they're like, and what will he have? My buddy was like, I'm guessing a talk with your manager. Free dinner.
Oh, he's genius. I love him.
Thank you. This is the best make-a-wish ever. Thank you.
My name is Alex Hooper from Los Angeles, California.
And tell me why you've entered the show this year.
I just want to inspire the world through happiness, positivity, and comedy.
I like that.
I love a good belly laugh.
Me too.
All right, Alex, well, look, you've got about 2 minutes, so good luck.
Thank you. Before I begin, I'd like to acknowledge your host, Tyra Banks. I truly admire your courage. It must be so difficult to host a show like this and still find a way to make it about you.
Okay.
That wasn't very nice. Somebody get his ass.
Oh, that was just an appetizer. Howie Mandel.
Yes.
A Canadian judging America's Got Talent? What happened? Did they already find all three talented Canadians? wanted to know what a big toe would look like if it were a person. Enough with Bobby's world. Let's move on to Spice World.
Oh, gosh.
Mel B. Scary Spice, hey, the only thing scary about you was your solo career. Magical. Four children, and yet your body looks as though you haven't paid attention to any of them.
Oh, no, he didn't.
Heidi, you are a natural beauty. Why does it look like your face went through a Sephora sample sale?
Oh, my God.
What? I want to hear what you're going to say about
Simon.
Oh,
I'm getting to him. Don't you worry! Simon!
Hello.
Simon, I'm confused. Didn't we form this country to get away from Brits like you? Calm down, peasants, calm down! But Simon, from all of us, thank you for fixing your British teeth. Those things are so straight and white, they were just offered positions in Trump's cabinet.
What's your name?
My name is Samuel J. Comroe. I'm a stand-up comedian.
Oh, wow. How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing comedy for 10 years now.
Do you do it full-time?
Yeah, do it full-time.
Okay. Are you nervous?
No, I have Tourette syndrome, so I twitch a lot. I blink real fast. My head flops around. If you see that, it's kind of cute.
It is.
Thank you.
And what does this mean to you, coming to AGT now?
This means everything. I've worked my entire life for a moment like this. They don't come very often. I'm really grateful. I just had a baby girl. And this is a beautiful opportunity.
Wow. And your family's all supportive of this career?
Yes, since I started, they've been 100% behind me, so I'm very thankful.
All right. Well, you know what? It's scary enough doing whatever you do to hit that X, and I just want the best for you.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Go ahead.
Thank you. So like I said, I have Tourette syndrome. It's why my head flops around. I blink real fast. It's weird. It always looks like I'm trying to tell you a secret. This twitch gets me in trouble. My roommate came home from work. I was like, dude, our neighbor died. He said, did you kill him? I was like, nah. Yo, this is a true story. When I was 10 years old, my parents sent me to Tourette's camp. Yeah, that's where the joke should end. It's a real place, and I didn't realize it till this moment, but I found out that when other people twitch, it makes me twitch more. So on the first day, they put us in a circle with 100 kids.
Oh, no.
The kid next to me did a shoulder roll. And my Tourette saw that and took that as a challenge. And I threw him a head flop. The girl next to him did a full body twitch, and everybody saw that, and all hell broke loose.
That is funny.
Kids were rolling on the ground. I was in the corner like, why'd they send us here? Our parents were on top of a hill like, oh, they're breakdancing. I'm Samuel J. Conroe. Thank you.
Hi. And what's your name?
Gatis Kandis.
Where are you from?
Latvia.
Okay, from Latvia. Why did you come here?
I came here to live.
My name is Gatis Kandis, and I'm originally from Latvia, but now I live in West Hendon near Sainsbury's, and I'm gonna be doing stand-up comedy. At the gigs I've been doing, people usually laugh, but then sometimes I get heckled and it's painful. And sometimes they're just quiet, which is also painful. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing Simon, and then I found out Carmen Electra's gonna be there. Very excited to see her. And the other two judges.
Well, David Williams is obviously, he's a comedian.
All right, okay. I didn't know that David's gonna be there. Okay.
Do you know who he is?
No.
Okay, good luck.
Okay.
Okay, hello. Are there any guys with big muscles in the audience? No, good, then I'll talk about them. You know, those big muscles make those guys so heavy that they cannot ride a pony. However, they can break a fragile toilet seat. I mean, do they work out to attract the ladies? Well, actually, the ladies are attracted to what's inside of a man. Back me up, ladies. If you agree, say yeah. Rapidly moving on. Public toilets, can't live without them, can't live in them either. Because there is no fridge and microwave there. Often when I use the male toilet, some guys there fart very loud, and I don't like that. So when possible, I sneak into the ladies' toilets instead, because they're much more discreet about it. Well, at least when they know that I am there. Seeing is believing, and weeing is relieving.
He's the funniest bloke we've had in Hammersmith.
More? Yes. Are you well?
Yeah.
No, you're not a well. You're a person.
What is going on here?
You are the funniest, unfunniest comedian I have ever heard in my life. I mean, absolute rubbish, but it actually really, really made me laugh.
Yeah, that was my aim, to make you laugh.
Well, you certainly did that, Gatis.
It was so bad that it was actually brilliant.
Yeah. You mustn't change. You seriously must not change.
Not even the jumper. Keep the jumper.
Well, what's wrong with my jumper?
There's nothing wrong with it. It's hilarious.
I'm going to kick this off because you did actually make me laugh, and that's what comedians are supposed to do, so I'm going to say yes.
I'm going to say yes. It's a no from me today.
Oh.
David? So it rests with me. The way you must judge comedy is, did it make you laugh? Made me laugh. I'm going to say yes.
Yes.
Well done. You're talking as well. Well done.
My name is Cam Bertrand. I'm a stand-up comedian from Tampa, Florida.
You're from Tampa, Florida.
My accent's all over the place. Through the set, you'll hear it fluctuate. It's weird. Public school and, I don't know, I'm weird.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, we did it.
So you said you are a stand-up comedian.
Yes, I am.
Yes.
I've been doing stand-up for about 8 years now.
And how did you get into that?
When I was a kid, I would stay up far past my bedtime, and I would watch more comedy than a kid probably should. It's actually how I first saw Howie. Yeah.
Also, that was a long, long time ago.
Cam, good luck to you.
Thank you. I actually just turned 27. I celebrated my birthday a couple weeks ago. Yeah, it's weird turning 27 because I feel like I'm getting older, but my face isn't. Yeah, it's strange. Like, it's tough having a baby face, you know, because, like, all I wanted to do for my birthday was to celebrate by getting a nice bottle of wine, you know, like an adult. But when I went to the store, I picked out the bottle I wanted. I went to the counter. I put it on the counter, as you do for purchases, right? And the lady looked at me. She looked at the bottle. She looked back at me, and she went, ha! No! That was it. That was the whole transaction. That's not protocol. You don't just get to go, no! Right? I was upset. I wasn't mad that she thought I was underaged. I get it. I look 17 at best. I wasn't mad she thought I was young. But I was upset that she thought an underaged person would be buying wine. Right? Like, I don't understand. In what world do you live in, Rebecca, where some 17-year-old dude is showing up to this house party like, y'all not gonna believe this. I got Pinot Grigio! Yeah, got that Grigio! Let's do shots of Chardonnay. Let's start a book club! Yeah. It's never happened, right? You don't know a 17-year-old that owns a corkscrew. That's weird, all right? Not one time in your entire life can you tell me a time where you've seen a 17-year-old dude be like, This Merlot pairs so well with the Doritos Locos Taco.
Oh, that's good.
It is just something about Zinfandels in a Hot Pocket that is to die for. I think there's two things alcohol-wise we should stop IDing for altogether, right? Wine and bourbon. Yeah, because no matter how old you are, if you're drinking them, you've earned it. Think about it. If you're drinking wine, clearly you have a lot of emotions and you're going through some things. And if you're drinking bourbon, you have no emotions. You've been through some things. Thank you, guys. It's been my time.